Have you ever looked at your situation and thought things were hopeless? Or have you ever wondered if your hopelessness was caused by your inadequacy? God wants you to know that no matter what things look like, as long as there is life and breath, there is always hope. You are never, ever without hope because you are never, ever without Christ. In Matthew 28 and 20, Jesus said, "Lo, I'm with you always, even until the end of the age." So Jesus is always with you. He is always in you, and He is always working on your behalf. God has a plan for you, and it's a good plan. Don't let anyone tell you that you're inadequate, and don't let anyone try to convince you that you're hopeless. You have a future and a hope all because of Jesus. So don't let anybody tell you differently. You see, hope is not wishing on a star or the luck of the draw. Hope is the expectation of good things to come. Hope is a person, and that person is Jesus. He is the one who has called you and equipped you to carry out His will and His purpose in your life. Your gifts and callings are under full warranty. Did you know that? They can never be canceled, reverted, or taken back. The Bible says in Romans chapter 11, verse 29, "For the gifts and the call of God are irrevocable." What that means is your mistakes, your mess-ups, your dead ends, and your detours can never change, shortchange, or cancel your gifts and the call that is on your life. So when you sin, keep a short account with God. He is the God of second chances. As a matter of fact, He is the God of as many chances as you need to get it right. Now, whenever a man wants to do good, the Bible says evil will always be present. So consider it a compliment. If you're trying to do something for God, if you're trying to live a life that's pleasing to Him, expect some opposition. The enemy of your soul will try to distract you, discourage you, deter you, and defeat you. He'll convince you that God can't use you because of your past or your weaknesses. Identity theft is nothing new to your adversary. He's been trying to steal man's identity since the beginning of time. He's on a mission to keep you from reaching your full potential, and maybe at times you've thought less of yourself. Maybe you think that God can't use you because you're a high school dropout. You might think you're too old, or that you're past your prime, or that you're damaged goods because you're a former addict, or that you don't measure up, or that you don't have what it takes. You might think God can't use you because you've got issues. Well, God has always used people with issues. Most of the people God used in the Bible had issues. So those of us with issues, we're in good company. Check out some of the people in the Bible God used in spite of their weaknesses. Abraham and Sarah were old. David was a murderer. Jonah was disobedient. Moses stuttered. Noah got drunk. Naomi was a widow. Rahab was a prostitute. Jeremiah was suicidal. Mary was a teenage mother. Joseph was a stepfather. Matthew was known to dip into the treasury. Thomas was a doubter. Peter was a deceiver. And Lazarus, well, Lazarus was dead. So what's your excuse? God used them anyway, and He'll continue to use you anyway in spite of your weaknesses. Actually, He'll use you because of your weaknesses. That way, you, God, and everyone else will know that when the miracle happens, it was God who did it, and God deserves the credit. There was a time in my own life when I was a bit confused about my own identity and who I thought I was. I've never been what you call a traditional gospel singer. I've never been one of those singers who could shout at the top of my lungs and do all of those vocal licks and runs. So when I started recording music, I didn't sing, and I still don't sing the kind of music that others might define as typical black gospel music. I write and sing ballads like "With All My Heart," "Each One Reach One," "When You Can't Trace His Hand, Trust His Heart," "To the Cross," and "All Rise." I write and sing what I believe God has given me to write and sing. In the early days, some people were actually surprised when they came to my concerts and learned that I was black. That kind of messed with my head. I used to think that my music and my voice sounded too white for black people and too black for white people, and that made me feel kind of gray, like I didn't fit in. For many years, I felt inadequate about my music and my voice. But over the years, as I began to do more concerts, I saw something beautiful beginning to emerge. A beautiful cross-section of races, cultures, and denominations were coming together in worship in my concerts. As I look back on it now, I can see that God used and is still using this ministry to serve as a bridge to bring the body of Christ together, not a category to keep people apart. I saw that God had a plan for me and that I fit into His plan just perfectly. So if you're struggling with an identity crisis that causes you to wonder who you are or where you fit in, listen to the voice of God reminding you that you are well able. You can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. You're an overcomer. You're not going under. You're going over. Let God's word assure you that you're equipped for the task. I call Philippians 4:13 the 10-finger prayer. Count the words off with me. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. So remember today as we pray that because of Jesus, there is hope for you. You're enough because Jesus is enough. You're established, enabled, and empowered. Now make this declaration. Repeat this after me. Today I will celebrate the truth that there is always hope for me. And because there is hope for me, I will not hide my gifts and try to blend in, but exercise my gifts to stand out for the glory of God. Let's pray together now. Dear Father, thank you that because of Jesus, we are more than conquerors. In you, there is no such thing as a hopeless case. We recognize that your strength is made perfect in our weakness. So we exchange our issues for your confidence and our inadequacy for your sufficiency. So use us, Lord, for our good and for your glory. And it's in the sweet name of Jesus we pray. Amen.